Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys the combiner. If you click here in the gray area, normally we click on a node and we have the add node options of serial, parallel, layer, and outside. You can actually split your nodes with a splitter or a combiner. So if you click in the gray area, you'll get a new prompt, add node, and here's where you can choose just a regular corrector, parallel mixer, layer mixers, key mixers, splitter, and combiner. So depending on what you need to do, you can split them out from a single node. I actually just add three serial nodes, right click, and you have channel options. So here I said channel one for the red channel. The second one is channel two for the green, channel three for the blue. So now depending on what channels are noisiest, you can use your three-dot menu here and you have a show viewer channels. So right now we're looking at the combined RGB, but you can actually look at just the red. So if we look in full screen mode, you can see all this blocking and noise because this is an 8-bit piece of media. And then if we look at the green channel, it's a lot less noisy and clean because I have some noise reduction going on in this channel. So if we take that off and full screen, here's the difference, just the green channel, which softens it a bit. So you can look and see which channel happens to be the noisiest. And we'll go ahead and look at the blue. And you can see major blocking in here. So let's go ahead and attack that and leave the red channel alone. And once again, if we look at red, it has some blocks, but it's not nearly as bad as blue. But primarily, I just wanted to show you guys, A, that you can split your channels up and combine them. So here I have a basic node in the front, taking all these, mixing them down. So this would be like your standard node when you start a color project. And then this splits them all into individual workable channels. Let's go back to our default view. And we'll go to the blue channel and let's go ahead and add some noise reduction. And this is a paid version only, but here down in where your color wheels normally are. So you might be on here. We have the option here at the very end, motion effects. This is where you get to your temporal noise reduction or your spatial. You can also add a little motion blur depending on what you're doing. So we have faster, better, enhanced, and ultra. This is new to version 19. If you say analyze, it sort of takes a look at an area it chooses. This is the neural engine deciding where it wants to look. You can resize this box if you'd like and move it around. And then you can also just set it up regular. And there's a blend mode. And then this essentially just makes a noise profile and adjusts your luma and chroma based on the noise that it's reading. But if we go back here and look at the blue channel, I'll stay on this node to enable and disable. I'll go back to the blue channel and go full screen, there's before and there's after. That's quite a bit of clarity. And then if we go back to our default view, RGB, the image is quite a bit softer. And let's go ahead and choose the blue node again. So you can really see down here, like in this corner. So you might not need to waste your noise reduction across the board because it does soften the image quite a bit. Right now we have it on two channels. Let's go ahead and disable this one. So now we have both disabled. Let's go ahead and highlight these two nodes. This red is still highlighted. So now I have the green and blue channels. Let's go back to full screen. Now you can really see it if you look right here. That is how you can combine all your channels, work on each one separately. If you want to clean up just a single noisy channel, or you've got something you need to isolate on just the red, green, or blue channels alone, you don't have to work with them all combined. So right click your node, choose channel, which one you're looking at. And then as you can tell, if we disconnect any of these, pull out the green. We just have the red and the blue. So if you want to experiment and see how things are interacting, you can look at these combined colors with one of the links taken out and then combine it back in. So that's the combiner, and that can help you isolate channels or do just single channel noise reduction or any other kind of effect. So if you want to click on one of these nodes and just change the output, like if you think it's a little green here, we could pull the top end down, things like that. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys on the next video.